Hello Bookish friends, welcome to another Turkish Shelf video. In Turkish Shelf videos, I talk about the books written by Turkish authors that are translated to English or books that are taking place in my country, Türkiye. And today I want to evaluate The Other Side of the Mountain by Erendiz Atasu. Erendiz Atasu was born in Ankara 1947 as the single daughter of parents who are teachers. She graduated from Ankara College and then from Pharmacy Faculty Ankara University in 1968. She then became a doctor, assistant professor and professor of pharmacy in the same university. She worked until her retirement in 1997. She started writing short stories when she was 25. Her short stories were first published in literary journals in 1981. In her stories, she mostly talked about women's problems and status in the country. She also published research texts, essays, and articles about literary problems, women's liberty, secular community, and the revolutions in the new Turkish Republic. Her first story collection, titled Kadınlar da Vardır, was published in 1983. Her first novel, Dağın Öteki Yüzü, which was translated as The Other Side of the Mountain, was published in 1995. Her works were translated to English, German, and Greek. The Other Side of the Mountain and A Midlife Dream are the novels that are translated to English. Atasu is a mother and a grandmother currently living in Istanbul. Dağın Öteki Yüzü was first published in 1995. The book was praised a lot critically and received the National Orhan Kemal Novel Gift Award in 1996. Novel was published to English with the title The Other Side of the Mountain by Millet Publishing. The book was translated by Elizabeth Malsen. The book talks about the life in New Turkish Republic through three generations of a modernist and a secular family. The story is told from different points of view, but mostly through different women characters. It follows a stream of conscious writing style in parts. The book talks about Balkan Wars, forced immigration, two world wars, Turkish independence war, Kurdish rebellion in Dersim, Korean War, and other political events and their effects on this family and the Turkish society. The transformation of family sort of mirrors the transformation of the Turkish society. Characters in the book and some of the events were inspired by Atasu's own family. Vicdan is the main character in the book. She is inspired by Atasu's mother. She is a teacher sent to master's study in England by the Turkish state and then worked as a teacher in different cities of Anatolia. She is sensible, selfless and reserved character, and also a fierce defendant of Turkish revolutions. Nefise is Vicdan's best friend. She is also sent to England with Vicdan. Her character is the opposite of her best friend. She is outgoing and quite selfish. She is always a bit jealous of Vicdan, although she loves her very, very much. Raik, who is Vicdan's husband, has a similar character as his wife and has the same political views, and the couple always support each other. He is also a teacher. Reha, Burhan and Cumhur are the smaller brothers of Vicdan. They all become soldiers. Reha and Burhan fight in Dersim, whereas Cumhur fights in Korean War. Burhan especially goes through a social transformation which Vicdan despises. We also have an unnamed narrator who is the daughter of Vicdan and Raik. She is quite rebellious towards her parents and challenges their views on the Turkish Revolution at times. What did I think about this book? Considering that The writing style, stream of conscience, is a writing method that I always find it difficult to read. I was surprised by how much I liked this book. It could be because I really did like the characters in the book. And also the family's history sort of mirrored both my paternal and maternal grandparents. So it was really easy to understand the quirks and the nuances of the characters. So it was easy to identify with the plot. Although I found the book to be not completely natural, I thought the positives and the negative sides of the Turkish Revolution in the new Turkish Republic was given quite justly. Maybe because I feel very, very positive towards modern and secular community that is enforced by Mustafa Kemal Atatürk in the new Republic. I also quite bonded with the theme of the book. It could have been shorter. And like I said before, stream of conscious writing method is not a method that I feel comfortable with. I really would advise this book to my international friends to really understand how the Turkish modernist revolution affected the country and the Turkish community through a family that fully supports this revolution. Considering the characters in this book and some of the events were inspired by the author's own family, I thought it was a quite realistic fiction book. To sum it all up, I gave The Other Side of the Mountain by Erendiz Atasu an 8 out of 10, and I'm thinking of reading more books from Erendiz Atasu in the future. So those were my thoughts on The Other Side of the Mountain by Erendiz Atasu. Please comment down below. Is there a special book that you would want me to make a Turkish video of? If you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! So Turkish word of the day, I'm going to choose mountain. Mountain means dağ in Turkish, and dağ is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day!